There are times after heavy rains when the water must be removed from a construction site in order to continue work. Dewatering without removal of the sediment pollutes our lakes and streams. There are products and techniques that remove most of the sediment so cleaner water is discharged from the site. Using dewatering bags is one option. Water is pumped into the dewatering bag and the bag acts as a filter to remove sediment, resulting in cleaner water discharge to the storm drains. Another option is construction of a dewatering area on your site. You could do this in several ways, making a small pit or a trap that the water would sit in, and given enough time, all of the debris will settle to the bottom, leaving clean water that can be discharged. If you have a grassy area on the site, that would be another option to run the water across the grass, and the grass will help to filter out a lot of those pollutants as well. Sometimes you may use all three of those techniques at the same time. So when pouring concrete, the concrete has a lot of chemicals in it that are really damaging to the environment. And the concrete that's actually poured here that's plastic isn't going anywhere. And that's not really what we're concerned about. But when you wash off the tools or wash off the concrete truck, the chute, those pollutants, those chemicals are really mobile and they can soak into the ground, get into our groundwater, or they can run off into our lakes and rivers. So we want to make sure that we handle that stuff properly. A lot of concrete suppliers will actually haul the liquid waste back when they leave the site. They have systems on the truck to clean off their chutes and equipment and recycle that water with all the waste in it. Sometimes if you're doing a small operation, you might be mixing stuff by hand and you don't have that concrete supplier, in which case you have to find a different way to manage those liquid wastes when you're cleaning up your equipment. One good rule of thumb is to only mix as much as you need, and think about keeping your quantities small and really conserving the amount of water that you use and limit the amount of liquids that you have to deal with. So if you have a lot of liquid concrete wastes on your site that aren't being hauled off by the supplier, you're going to need to deal with those somehow. One option is to have a piece of plastic and dig a hole in the ground and just keep all of that waste contained into the plastic. A product that kind of does that for you is called the Outpack. It's really just a cardboard box that folds up nice and small when you don't need it. But then as soon as you're ready to use it, you can open it up, put in the liner, and you really have a nice containment space for your liquid concrete waste. So the advantage is here, it stores nice and small before you're going to use it. Another option would be to just buy a plastic kiddie pool or something like that, and again, put all of your liquid waste in there. Either of these options, you're going to have to somehow deal with those liquid wastes in the long run. If it all evaporates out and you have cured, hardened material in the bottom, great, that's easy to deal with. You can just bag this up and put it in the dumpster or dispose of it that way. If it is a liquid and you have to get rid of it, you're going to need a contract with a waste hauler who deals with liquids. Commonly, the services, bathroom sanitation facilities, those can also deal with these sorts of liquid waste, so that would be one option. Although your site may be small, the cumulative impacts of pollutants from improperly managed construction sites contributes to the degradation of our lakes and streams. Do your part to keep the pollution on your site and out of our waters.